हेलो, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज़ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग। आज के इस वीडियो में हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन्स, जो जनरली पूछे जाते हैं एसएससी, एमपीएससी एंड इवन गेट एग्जाम्स में। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो। सो द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज काइनेमेटिक्स ऑफ मशीन डील्स विथ, एंड द ऑप्शंस आर एपरेटस फॉर अप्लाइंग द मैकेनिकल पावर, number of interrelated part, the forces acting on the parts of the machine, the relative motion between the parts neglecting the consideration of force. And the answer is the relative motion between the parts neglecting the consideration of the forces, because kinematics is the study of motion apart from the forces which produces that motion. It is the branch of theory of machine which deals with the study of relative motion of various elements of machine without taking into consideration the forces which act upon them. So basically, in kinematics of machine, we study the relative motion between the parts, and while studying the relative motion, we completely neglect the forces which are acting on the various links, or the forces which are nothing but the cause for the relative motion, that we neglect. And we focused on the relative motion between the various part. The second question, the mechanism used in a petrol engine is, options are crank mechanism, slider crank mechanism, natural line and circular mechanism. And the answer is slider and crank mechanism. So here in this diagram, you can see the slider and crank mechanism. So in this mechanism, the cylinder is a fixed component, then the slider, connecting rod and the crank. These are nothing but four different links in this mechanism, and the mechanism used in petrol engine is slider and crank mechanism. Why it is known as a slider and crank mechanism? Because it is having a slider and a crank as a component. Third question, dynamics of machine deals with, and the option are the relative motion between the parts neglecting the consideration of forces, the forces acting on the parts of the machine, the apparatus for applying the mechanical power, the number of interrelated parts each having a definite motion. And the answer is the forces acting on the parts of the machine. So basically, in dynamics of machine, we are interested in the forces acting on the parts of the machine. So dynamics is the branch of classical mechanics concerned with the study of forces and their effects on the motion. So in kinematics of machine, we study the relative motion, whereas in dynamics of machine, we study the forces acting on the various components of the machine. Fourth question, which of the following is a lower pair? Options are piston and cylinder, cam and follower, belt drive, gear. And the answer is piston and cylinder. So a lower pair is one in which there occurs a surface or area contact between the two members. Examples are nut and screw, universal joint, which is used to connect two propeller shaft. So basically, in lower pair, there should be a surface contact, and there is a surface contact in between piston and cylinder. So the answer is piston and cylinder. Fifth question, in a kinematic chain, the minimum number of kinematic pairs required is, the option are 1, 2, 3, 4. So the answer is 4. So here in this diagram, you can see the kinematic chain, which is made up of four different links. And kinematic pair is nothing but the connection in between two links. So here, the first link is connected to second, second is connected to third, third is connected to fourth, and four is connected to one. So ultimately, we are getting four different kinematic pair. Okay, so the answer is option D, 4. Next question, a kinematic chain requires minimum of two links and three turning pair, three links and three turning pair, three links and four turning pair, and the last one, four link and four turning pair. So the answer is 4 link and 4 turning pair. So here in this diagram, you can see two different kinematic chain. So in first chain, the first link is fixed, then second, third and fourth. So in first example, there are four different links, out of which the first link is fixed. Okay. So total four links are there, and the first is connected to second, second is connected to third, third is connected to fourth, and fourth one is connected to again first, as it is a fixed link. So in first example, you can see there are four different link and four turning pair. Now we will see second example. So in second example, first link is fixed. Then there is a second link, third link. The fourth link, we can see, we can take as a slider. So it is a slider and crank mechanism. So it has three turning pair and one sliding pair. So the second example is not suitable for this question. We will concentrate on first. So in first example, you can see four turning pairs are there and four links. So kinematic chain requires minimum four links and four turning pair. Or we can see four links, three turning pair, one sliding pair. That also we can consider. But here the option is four links are there and four turning pair. So the answer is four links and four turning pair. Next question, in case of lower pair, options are, there is a surface contact between two elements while in motion, there is a line contact between two elements while in motion, there is a point contact between two elements while in motion, the contact is only at the lower end of the two elements while in motion. And the answer is, there should be a surface contact between the two elements while in motion. So here you can see the examples of lower pair, and you can see there is a surface contact in between two elements. The first element is shown in red color, whereas the second element is shown in the blue color, we can say. So there is a surface contact in between the two elements. Next question, in case of higher pair, options are, there is a contact only at higher point of the two elements while in motion. There is only a line or point contact between the two elements while in motion. There is only a line or point contact between the two elements while in motion. There is no contact between the two elements. The option is, there is only line or point contact between the two elements while in motion. So this is an example of higher pair, the cam and follower, which you can see over your screen. So here there is a point contact in between the follower and the cam. So in case of higher pair, there can be a line contact or the point contact between the two elements when they are in motion. Next question, in case of an elliptical trammel, options are, one pair turns and three pair slide, two pair turn and two pair slide, three pair turn and one pair slide, all four pair turn. And the option is, two pair turn and two pair slide. So here you can see an example of elliptical trammel. Here there are two sliders, this slides in the guide, the link 1 which is fixed, and link 3 that connects the link that connects the two different slider. So in between link 3 and link 4 there is a turning pair, again in between link 3 and link 2 there is a turning pair, whereas in between link 1 and link 2 sliding pair, and link 1 and link 4 again there is a sliding pair. So in case of elliptical trammel, there are two turning pair and two sliding pair. Next question, two parallel shafts, the distance between whose axis is small and variable, may be connected by, options are, gear drive, universal joint, clutch arrangement, knuckle joint, Oldham's coupling. And the answer is Oldham's coupling. So when you want to join the two parallel shafts, but they are at some distance, their axes are at some distance, in that case you can connect those shafts with the help of Oldham coupling. So here you can see an image of schematic of Oldham's coupling and the actual image of Oldham's coupling. So with this coupling you can connect the two parallel shafts whose axes are at some distance. Next question, the Ackermann steering gear consists of four bar mechanism with, the options are, only one turning pair and three sliding pair, only two turning pair and low pair sliding, only three pair turning and one pair sliding, all four pair turning. And the option is all four pair turning. So here on the screen you can see the Ackermann mechanism, and here you can see all the pairs are turning pair. So This is nothing but a four bar mechanism which is used. Sorry. So here you can see a four bar mechanism, and in this four bar mechanism all pairs are turning there. The next question, which one of the following is higher pair? Options are Thomson indicator mechanism, double Maclean indicator mechanism, Hart's straight line mechanism, tooth gearing mechanism. And the option is tooth gearing mechanism, because in gears there is a sliding as well as turning pair. The two gears, they are turned with respect to each other, whereas their teeth slides over each other. And when there is a sliding and turning motion, or when there is a sliding and turning contact while the two elements are in motion, then it forms a higher pair. Next question, the mechanism used to enlarge or reduce the movements for reciprocating drawing to different scale is known as clinograph, graphometer, tri-square, durograph, pantograph. And the answer is pantograph. So here on the screen you can see the pantograph. So we can enlarge the existing image with the help of pantograph. Next question, in case of cam and follower mechanism, for uniform velocity of the follower, the displacement curve will have. The answer is constant slope. So here you can see the displacement diagram of a follower for the uniform velocity, and during the period of rise and during the period of fall, you can see a constant slope. The next question, a point on the link connecting double slider crank chain traces A. Options are straight line path, circular path, parabolic path, hyperbolic path, elliptical path. And the answer is elliptical path. So here you can see a double slider crank mechanism, and on the link 2 I have taken one point, that is point P, and during the motion that point P will trace an ellipse. So the answer is elliptical path. The next question, the number of instantaneous center for a 4 bar chain mechanism would be? The answer is 6. So here on the screen you can see a 4 bar mechanism which is having 4 different links, out of which the first link is fixed. Now there is a formula for calculating the instantaneous center. The formula is n equal to small n in bracket small n minus 1 divided by 2. So here n is nothing but the number of links, and here the number of links are 4. So 4 in bracket 4 minus 1 divided by 2, that will give 6. So the number of instantaneous center for a 4 bar chain mechanism is 6. The next question, a radial follower is? The options are one that reciprocates in the guide, second one that oscillates, third one in which the follower translates along an axis passing through the cam center of the rotation, fourth one in which the axis of the following movement is displaced from the cam center. And the answer is one in which the follower translates along an axis passing through the cam center of the rotation. So here you can see the cam and follower mechanism, and the follower axis is passes through the axis of the camshaft. And when such condition is there, it is known as radial follower. The next question, cam size depends on what? Options are cam operating speed, pitch circle, base circle, prime circle. So the cam size depends on the base circle. Answer is C, base circle. So here you can see the nomenclature of cam and follower, and the smallest circle that can be drawn to the cam, that is known as base circle. And the cam size depends on what? It depends on the base circle. Next question, a pair is termed as higher pair when the relative motion between the two element of the pair is? The options are turning only, sliding only, rolling only, partly sliding, partly turning. And the answer is partly sliding, partly turning. So here you can see the example of gears. So the two gears, they turn with respect to each other. So partly turning motion is there. Also the tooth teeth, they slides over each other. So in gearing mechanism, the two gears, they turn with respect to each other. Also, they slides over each other. And that is nothing but an example of higher pair. Next question. A cylindrical type cam is one. Options are with cylindrical roller follower, with cylindrical shape of follower, with circumferential counter cut in the surface of the cylinder, which rotates about its axis, with circular type of follower. And the option is with circumferential counter contour cut in the surface of the cylinder, which rotates about the axis. So here on the screen, you can see an example of cylindrical cam. Over the cylindrical cam, circumferential contour is cut, which rotates about its axis. And the next question. The throw of the cam is the maximum distance of the follower from, the options are starting to finish, base circle, pitch circle, root circle. And the answer is second option, that is base circle. So here on the screen, you can see the lift of the cam, which is denoted by follower travel. So follower travel, that is nothing but the distance from the follower travel, that is nothing but the distance from the base circle. So here you can see the distance over your screen. So this is nothing but the follower travel, that is also known as lift of the follower. So it is taken from the base circle. This is nothing but the base circle. Okay, so this is the base circle and the distance is taken from the base circle. So the throw of the cam is the maximum distance from the maximum distance of the follower from the base circle. Next question. Idler pulley is used for, options are maintaining belt tension, changing the direction of rotation, for stopping the motion frequently, for running during the idling period only. And the option is maintaining belt tension. So here you can see the two different pulleys are there, and on that pulley there is a belt, and idler pulley is used for maintaining the belt tension. The next question. A belt drive is, a belt drive is, option is not, the answer is not a positive drive. Okay, so a belt drive is not a positive drive because there exists a slip in a belt drive. The belt may slip over the pulley. That is why it is not a positive drive. Whereas in gear, gear is considered as a positive drive because you are getting exact velocity ratio, which is not possible in belt drive. So it can be considered as a non-positive drive. The next question. The pulley in the belt drive act as a, options are cylindrical pair, sliding pair, rolling pair, turning pair. So the answer is rolling pair. So here you can see the example of belt drive. There are two different pulleys and over which the belt is traveling. So the pulley is nothing but, the pulley in a belt drive act as a rolling pair because the belt rolls over the pulley. Next question. A nut and bolt forms a, options are turning pair, rolling pair, spherical pair, sliding pair, helical pair. And the answer is helical pair because helical threads are cut over the nut as well as bolt. So it forms a helical pair. Next question. The angle of the V belt is 30 degree, 35 degree, 40 degree, 45 degree. So here you can see the cross section of the V belt, and the angle of the V belt, that is nothing but the inclined belt angle. So that is kept 40 degree. Next question. Sensitiveness of the governor is, the options are the range of variations of the engine speed, the ratio of maximum speed to minimum speed within the operating range, the ratio of difference between the maximum and mean speed to that of minimum to mean speed, the ratio of difference between the maximum and minimum equilibrium speed to the mean equilibrium speed. The answer is the ratio of the difference between the maximum and minimum equilibrium speed to the mean equilibrium speed. Okay, so let N1, that is nothing but the minimum speed corresponding to no load condition, N2 is maximum speed corresponding to full load condition. We can take mean speed as N1 plus N2 divided by 2. And range of speed can be given as N2 minus N1 because N2 is maximum speed and N1 is minimum speed. So sensitiveness is equal to what? Range divided by mean speed. So sensitiveness equal to twice in bracket N2 minus N1 divided by N1 plus N2. So the answer for this question is the ratio of difference between the maximum and minimum equilibrium speed to the mean equilibrium speed. Next question, timing belt. Options are have no slip, have maximum speed during the starting, slip in the proportion to the time of operation are used to determine the life of time of a belt. And the answer is have no slip. So here on the screen you can see the timing belt. So in case of timing belt, there are teeth on the inner portion of the belt as well as the teeth cut over the periphery of the pulley, and due to which there is no slip. That is why timing belt have no slip. Next question. The pitch circle of the cam is, options are the smallest circle drawn to the pitch curve from the center of rotation of the curve. Second, the circle with the center as the center of cam axis and radius such that it passes through the pitch point. And the answer is the circle with the center as a center of cam axis and radius such that it passes through the pitch point. So here you can see the pitch circle. This is nothing but the nomenclature of cam and follower. So pitch circle that says through the pitch point. So here I can show you, this is a pitch circle and this pitch circle that is passing through the number of pitch point. So pitch point is nothing but the point at which there is a maximum pressure angle, and the collection of these pitch points is nothing but your pitch circle. Next question, the pitch point on the cam is, options are any point on the pitch curve, the point on the cam pitch circle having the maximum pressure angle, any point on the pitch curve, a point at a distance equal to the pitch circle radius from the center. And the option is the point on the pitch circle having maximum pressure angle. So here you can see this is nothing but a pitch point. And on this pitch point, you can get a maximum pressure angle. You can get a maximum pressure angle on this pitch point. So, the pitch point on a cam is nothing but the point on the cam pitch circle having maximum pressure angle. Next question. In case of hypoid gear, the mutual position of the shaft will be parallel, intersecting, non-parallel, non-intersecting, non-parallel, non-intersecting. Option is non-parallel, non-intersecting. So here on the screen you can see the example of hypoid gear. Their axes are not parallel to each other and even they are not intersecting each other. Next question. For two meshing gears, their options are number of teeth must be same, addendum must be same, dedendum must be same, clearance must be same, module must be same. And the option is module must be same. So the formula for calculating the module is diameter of the gear divided by number of teeth on that gear. Formula is diameter of the gear in millimeter divided by number of teeth of that gear. That gives the module. And for meshing these two different gears, the module should come same. So here there are two different gears. They are meshing with each other. And they can mesh with each other only when their module will be same. Next question. While evaluating the minimum number of teeth on a pinion, the major consideration is, options are, the minimum diameter of the pinion, the shaft diameter on which the pinion is to be mounted, to avoid the interference, to minimize the clearance. Answer is, to avoid the interference. So while evaluating the minimum number of teeth on the pinion, the major consideration is nothing but to avoid the interference. And here on the screen, in this diagram, you can see what exactly the interference is. So this is nothing but the interference. This is an interference. So the size of the gear tooth should be less than the tooth space. Okay. So while evaluating the minimum number of teeth on the pinion, the major consideration is to avoid the interference. Next question, in case of gear, the pressure angle is, the options are, the angle between the line of action and the common tangent to the pitch surface in the plane of rotation, the angle between the normal to the point of contact and the shaft axis. So the answer is the first option, the angle between the line of action and the common tangent to the pitch surface in the plane of rotation. So here you can see the pressure angle. So it is nothing but an angle between the common tangent and the line of action that gives the pressure angle. Next question. The differential gear in the automobile is used to, options are, reduce speed, assist in changing speed, provide balancing, help in turning. The answer is help in turning. So here you can see the differential. Now while taking the turn, the outer wheel has to travel more distance as compared to your inner wheel, and that can be accomplished with the help of differential. So basically differential helps in turning. So the answer is the differential gear in the automobile is used to help in turning. Next question, the radial depth of the gear tooth below the pitch circle is, addendum plus dedendum, dedendum, addendum, dedendum minus clearance. So the radial depth of the gear tooth below the pitch circle. So here you can see the radial depth below the pitch circle. Now this is a pitch circle, okay, and dedendum is nothing but the radial distance below this pitch circle. So this portion is nothing but dedendum. So the answer is dedendum. So the radial depth of the gear tooth below the pitch circle is known as dedendum. Next question, which of the following instrument may be used in vibration measurement? Options are photometer, accelerometer, dynamometer, bellometer. The answer is accelerometer. So here on the screen you can see the accelerometer. So this is the accelerometer. Is nothing but the accelerometer that can be kept over the vibrating element, and that accelerometer is used for measuring the vibration. It can take the vibration signature. Here you can see the vibration signature that you can record over your screen with the help of accelerometer. Next question, a stretch string of a guitar when operated is subjected to, options are, free vibration, force torsional vibration, force transverse vibration, damped vibration. And the answer is force transverse vibration. So here you can see the guitar wire. So whenever the force is applied, that force is applied perpendicular to the axis of the bias, and due to the application of force, those guitar wires, they oscillates perpendicular to its own axis, and when there is vibrations perpendicular to the axis, then it is under transverse vibration, and these vibrations are produced due to application of force. That's why the answer is force transverse vibration. Next question, hammer blow in a locomotive results in, options are, pulsating torque, uniform torque, tendency to lift the wheel from the rail, uneven speed. So the answer is tendency to lift the wheel from the rail. So here you can see the wheel of the locomotive, and due to hammer blow, this wheel may lift from the rails. This wheel may lift from the rail. That is the effect of hammer blow. Next question. In governor, if the stiffness of the spring is increased, the governor wheel, options are, becomes more sensitive, becomes less sensitive, remain unaffected, starts hunting. So here you can see the Hartnell governor, and the option is it becomes less sensitive. Next question. For fluctuating loads, the appropriate bearing would be, options are, bush bearing, ball bearing, ball bearing with the sleeve, roller bearing, needle roller bearing. And the answer is needle roller bearing. So whenever there is a fluctuating load, you have to use needle roller bearing. And here on the screen you can see the image of needle roller bearing. So it is a roller bearing with needles. Next question. A kinematic chain becomes a mechanism when first link is fixed, any one link is fixed, all link are fixed, one of the link are fixed. So a kinematic chain, it becomes a mechanism when any one link is fixed. So the answer is any one link is fixed. So here you can see the example of a mechanism. So here in this mechanism, the first link is fixed. So you can fix any one link, and whenever any one of the link of a kinematic chain is fixed, you can get a mechanism. Okay. So here the first link is fixed. That is why I am getting certain mechanism. If I fix the second link, I will be getting another mechanism. So likewise, I can fix different link, and by fixing different link, I can get different mechanisms also. So the answer is any one link is fixed. Next question. Creep in the belt is due to, options are, elasticity of the belt material, plasticity of the belt material, elongation of the belt due to tension, differential elongation of the belt due to difference in tension on two sides of the pulley. And the answer is differential elongation of the belt due to difference in tension on two sides of the pulley. So here you can see the belt and pulley arrangement. So the first pulley, that is driving pulley, second one is driven pulley. The bottom side acts as a tight side, whereas the upper side acts as a slack side. So at bottom side there is a maximum tension, whereas on the upper side there is a minimum tension. So creep in the belt is due to what? Differential elongation of the belt due to differences in the tension of the two sides of the pulley. Next question. Motorcycle shock absorber are generally designed for, options are, partial damping, light damping, large damping, critical damping. And the answer is critical damping. So the motorcycles for the shock absorber are generally designed for the critical damping. Here on the screen you can see the shock absorber which are used in the motorcycle, and they are designed for the critical damping. Next question. The number of natural frequencies of three rotor system will be, options are, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the answer is 2. So for the three rotor system, you would be getting 2 natural frequencies. The next question. The objective of crowning of flat pulley of the belt drive is, options are, prevent the belt from running off the pulley, increase the power transmission capacity, increase the belt velocity, prevent the belt joint from damaging the belt surface. And the option is prevent the belt from running off the pulley. So here you can see this is the belt pulley. So this is the pulley, and they are crowned, okay. The surface is not exactly flat. This is a pulley, and surface of this pulley is not exactly flat. It is having some radius. This is known as crowning, and it is done to prevent the flat belt from running off. Okay, so that is known as crowning. So the answer is prevent the belt from running off the pulley. Next question. When sunk key is to be used, the key way is, the options are provided in shaft only, provided in hub only, provided both in shaft and hub. Key way is not provided for a sunk key. So whenever sunk key is used, the key way is provided both in the shaft and hub. So here you can see the sunk taper key. So this is the sunk key, and whenever it is used, the key way is provided, the key way is provided in the shaft as well as in the hub. Okay, so the option is provided both in shaft as well as in hub. Next question. In the cross-by engine indicator, which one of the following mechanism is used? Options are slider crank mechanism, scotch yoke mechanism, modified pantograph, and the option is scotch yoke mechanism. So here you can see the cross-by engine indicator as well as the scotch yoke mechanism. Next question. In case of an automobile, power is transmitted from the gearbox to the differential through. Options are bevel gear, hook joint, Oldham's coupling, none of above. And the answer is hook joint. So this is nothing but the hook joint. Okay. And the hook joint is provided in between the propeller shaft. So here you can see the hook joint. Okay. So the hook joint is used in between the propeller shaft and the gearbox, as well as in between propeller shaft and the differential. Okay. So the question was, in case of an automobile, power is transmitted from the gearbox to the differential through hook joint. Hook joint is also known as universal joint. The last question is, a swinging pendulum in its mid position possess. Options are only the potential energy, only the kinetic energy, more kinetic energy, less potential energy, none of above. And the answer is only the kinetic energy. So this is a pendulum system. So when it is get displayed, suppose it is at this position, and now I leave this pendulum from this position. Okay, so it will travel along this direction. Now at this point, the pendulum has potential energy. So whenever I leave this pendulum, that potential energy is converted to kinetic energy. So at the mid position, the pendulum has maximum kinetic energy. When this pendulum is reached from this point to this point, at this point, the pendulum will have maximum kinetic energy. Now, due to that kinetic energy, that pendulum will travel from this point towards this point. Okay, so during the travel, the kinetic energy will be converted into potential energy. And at this point, the pendulum will have only potential energy. The entire kinetic energy will be converted into potential energy. And again, due to that potential energy, this pendulum will try to come back to mid position along this direction. So again, that potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy, and it will be maximum at the mean position. So the question was, a swinging pendulum in its mid position possess only kinetic energy. The option is only the kinetic energy. So in this presentation, we have discussed total 51 questions. Hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching my video.